and save. All right, so we're going to continue on today with the pH scale. When we talk about the pH scale, and we'll also talk about the pOH scale, which is probably not as common as the pH scale, remember that the pH scale ranges from 0 to 14, okay? Also, what may not be in your notes, I don't think they are in your notes, is something else, that when we look at the pH of something, if we add pH and pOH together, that actually has a value of 14. Now, I don't believe that's in your notes. It probably would be a very good thing to put it in your notes. If you can remember from, might have been last week. Did we meet on Monday?
No.
Okay. So it was last week where we talked about, okay, if you have your hydrogen concentration and that was multiplied by your hydroxide concentration, what was that value equal to?
1.0 times 10 to the negative
14. Good. So it's 1.0 times 10 to the negative 14. What you don't realize is these two statements are very similar. And what I've done is I've actually taken the negative log of the hydrogen concentration to get my pH. I've taken the negative log of my hydroxide concentration to get my pOH. And if I take the negative log of this value here, take a wild guess at what number I get.
14.
Okay. So these two statements actually do represent each other very well. So that when we go and solve for these types of problems, knowing these two equations, you already have this one. I don't think I gave you that one in the notes, but knowing the relationship of these two is really helpful. Also, have you guys worked with logs before?
Yes.
Okay, so some of you have, some of you haven't. The nice thing about logs, this is a log base 10. Okay. What log base 10 is it talks about tenths. So the reason why if I take the negative log of this value, I get 14 is because I had to move the decimal place 14 times. So when we talk about log, there's different log bases. We are talking about log base 10, even though it doesn't note it down here. Typically, they'll have a 10 or whatever number it is down there. But for chemistry, it's always going to be a 10. Okay. The P, actually, when we talk about the P here, it's a math function. And really, that's what it represents. The P is a negative log math function. Now, I don't know if you ever learned that before, but the hydrogen here, or the H, represents your hydrogen concentration. So I could ask you to find the PCl. What would that represent? Negative log of the chlorine ions. Yeah. So we typically use pH and pOH because that's something that we can typically measure very easily. All right, so when you see the P, and again, you only see it in chemistry. I can't think of any math class that you'll see that in. Okay. So if you haven't written that down, make sure that you do. Also, you could be asked to find a pOH. Now, I would be very, very careful in using this equation here because you may not be totally comfortable. But the reason why I have this one on here is because of this equation that we had earlier where the pOH and the pH equals 14. So if I wanted to find the pOH, then to find this, remember that this is a negative log function of your hydrogen concentration. Okay. So I've actually combined this and this into one equation. My advice is I wouldn't even consider using this equation today. Okay. Until you're comfortable, all right? So you can use this one, which is very similar to this one. The difference is that we are looking, or we're given, a hydroxide concentration, okay? Now, once you've worked with these, probably tonight, and then you come back and look at this, you might go, oh yeah, that looks pretty easy, I can do that, okay? But the reason why I put this on here is because we do that a lot in AP, all right? All right. We'll do some calculations here in a second. Oh, here it is. pH plus pOH equals 14. Now, this is a little disturbing to some. Okay, and I apologize that it looks so crazy.
Craig, all of this is disturbing.
That's okay. That's all right. And some of you may want to focus just on the pH values. Now, we all know that the pH scale goes from typically from 0 to 14. If we're looking at 0 to 7, what can we say about that solution?
It's acidic.
It's acidic. Very good. The lower values represent a higher concentration of the hydrogen. So when, if your pH is actually less than 7, you're looking at an acidic solution. If we say that the pH is equal to 7, you're neutral. If your pH is greater than 7, then you're looking at a basic solution. Now, things get crazy when we start talking about pOH and the relationship there. It's just simply the opposite. If we have a pH or a pOH that's less than 7, then we have a basic solution. If the pH is greater than 7, it's an acidic solution. Now, some of you, that's going to drive you crazy. All right? So if that statement drives you crazy, focus on pH. Trust me, it will help out. And then you can answer your question and go, okay, well, it gave me a pOH. Well, what's the pH? Then I can tell if it's acidic or basic. Okay. All right. And here's just some problems worked out. Let's do some practice problems. Here's practice problem number 9.
Can you write in solid bases?
No. It says, calculate the pH of a 0.1 molar nitric acid solution. And it says that nitric acid is a strong acid. Really, what we care about is this, and that it's an acid. Okay? Because if you're given, it wants to know what is the pH for this, and we have hydrogen, then it's a pretty simple problem. So remember that the equation that was given is that the negative log of the hydrogen concentration will give you your pH. Now, this is kind of neat. Hopefully, if you have a value of 1 and then some, like a negative exponent, you should be able to do this in your head. Okay. If the value is 1. Now, if it's anything other than 1, then you'll definitely need your calculator. But if I have, say, the pH, which is equal to negative log of, I'm not going to write it like that, but I'm going to write it like this, 1.0 times 10 to the negative 2, and that's what this is, right? What should the pH for this be? 2. And type that in and just confirm it. So whatever your exponent is, as long as you have a value of 1 here, so if you have a 1 here, okay, whatever your exponent is, that's what your pH will be. Okay. Pretty cool. Now, if it's anything other than 1, like if it's 1.5, then you're going to need your calculator to get the actual value. So let's just throw another one out there. Let's say that you have, say, a concentration of 1 times 10 to the negative 9. What's your pH? 9. Pretty simple, right? Isn't that cool? All right. Let's take a look at the next one. Oops. Oh, it's over here. I'm getting used to it. All right, now, this one is asking for the pOH, okay? If you're given a pOH value, then we need to know what? We need to know the hydroxide concentration. Good. And sometimes I'll come out and tell you what it is. In this case, I do, but on the next one, I don't. So make sure that you recognize what this is. And if you need to, you may have to write it out. Okay, sodium hydroxide. There's the hydroxide. In the last one, go back. In the last problem, okay, we had hydrogen ions, and you had the concentration for that. Here, come back. Here, you're given a hydroxide concentration. So we know our hydroxide concentration is equal to 2.3 times 10 to the negative 4. That's what that is. So if I want to find the pOH, how do I do it? Take the negative log, yeah, of your concentration of your hydroxide. Which in this case, now this isn't one that I can look at and just spit out, but make sure you can get it on your calculator. What is it? 3.63? That sounds right. And make sure that your calculator can get that. Now, let's say that the problem didn't ask for POH, but maybe it asked for the pH for this sodium hydroxide solution. How would you find the pH? Well, knowing the POH, how could you find the pH?
You just look at the H.
No, there is no H. It's hydroxide.
Divided by 16.
What's that? Now remember this? pH plus POH equals what?
14.
There you go. So in this case, we have pH is equal to 14 minus the POH. Now how did I get that? Well, I subtracted this on both sides. So when you do that, those go away, so whatever that is.
14 minus
that. So 14 minus that, which is what, 9.437? Now it didn't ask for that, but I'm sure you'll see something like that soon. Hint, hint. Does everybody get that? I hear somebody saying, I get or don't get. I can't hear.
It's
10.37. Sorry. I blame the smart board now.
It just writes numbers for you.
I know. Stupid thing.
I think you
should take it home for me.
I would have laughed really hard if it
would
have fallen off.
Nope, it's pretty good. All right.
It's
like that. What is that?
Did it break?
Ooh, don't want to do that. All right. Try this next one on your own and no peeking up here. No peeking. I told you not to use what? No, I'm using it now. I didn't use that, did I? I broke it down into steps. I found the POH first, then I'm finding the pH. Yeah.
Where does the 14 come from?
Where does the 14 come from?
Yeah.
That is...
The
11, 11, 11, 11. I don't know if I still have it
is
yet.
Is it? Oh. Is this thing?
It's from. Where are you? This right here.
Okay.
Now, and again, that's the hydrogen concentration times the hydroxide equals 1.0 times 14. Take the negative log of all of those. That's what you get.
On the first problem, I did.
I'm sorry? Hang on, guys. Shh, shh, shh. I did not subtract from 14 because I did not need to, right? Since I had my hydrogen concentration, so I was good. And again, what I'm looking at is this up above. Okay. So since I had my hydrogen, I didn't need to subtract. I was good. Yeah.
So you just want to make sure you have hydrogen and not hydroxyl.
Make sure you know what's given. So if you have hydrogen, find the pH. If you have hydroxide, find the pOH. If it asks you to find the other, I would find what was given first, then subtract it from 14 if needed. So in that case, Brenna, we didn't need to subtract because we had our hydrogen.
Now, do you want to do that round up all the way to 70?
Oh, okay. Hang on. Shh. On your pH, always show two decimal places.
Okay.
So.
No, I mean, like, you went all the way up to 70, where it's like 11.65.
Oh, is it 6.5?
Yeah.
My calculator rounded. Stick that thing.
I just did that with that.
Yeah, thank you. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so is everybody good with this? Because now we're going to flip everything. Huh? All right, practice problem number 12. Now listen, because I haven't talked about this yet. This one wants to know what is the hydrogen concentration. Now I think I said in the notes that this is the same thing as this. And it is. It's just two different ways to represent the same thing. So in this case, it's asking for the concentration. And the brackets, again, represent concentration. Except now we're given the pH. So if you're given a pH, what that means is to get pH to concentration, we're not going to do what we just did, which was actually going from concentration to pH. How'd we do that? We took the negative log, right. So we took the negative log of our hydrogen concentration. Okay. So if we're going in the opposite direction, would we still take the negative log? No, we're actually you're going to take the anti-log. Do you know what the anti-log is? It's second log or shift log on your calculator. Anti-log. Okay. Except now, you will type in your negative pH, okay? That's why I was looking on the notes. I didn't see this anywhere. You need to write that down, okay? So if you're going from pH to the concentration, you're taking the anti-log, which is, I think on your calculator, a lot of you have it as a 10 to the X function. Whatever it is. Now, hold on. Make sure. Now, listen. You guys are chatty today. Make sure it's not this. This does not represent that. This does not represent that. Okay? These two buttons are completely different. This is to get you an exponent. This typically is a second button. Then you hit the log button. Two button sequence. Okay, that's typical for all calculators. All right, so these two buttons are a no-no to get this or anti-log. Typically, you have to do second log. So how would we go about and find the concentration? So hydrogen concentration is equal to the, and I want you to write anti-log, I don't want you to just write what your calculator is telling you, of this. And when you type that in, I hope you get something like this, or your calculator probably did this to you.
Can we leave it at that?
Sure, yep. That's fine, yep, it's all legal. Okay. Just don't write too many zeros, especially if scientific notation will clean that up for you. Okay. So again, in this case, you were given a concentration for the hydrogen. You were given the concentration for the hydrogen and is asking you to, I'm sorry, you were given the pH and is asking you for the concentration. Okay. All right. Try the next one on your own because it's still pretty straightforward.
So we don't have to find pH, then subtract.
I would not because, again, notice what you're given. You're given POH. You're not given a pH. Now, if you were given a pH, yes. Okay. And it's looking for the hydroxide. So if you're looking for that, then we're going to go hydroxide is equal to the anti-log of your negative 7.55.
How does that work though? You have 10, like 10 to the blank, like I have to put something there.
Something blank? Put it there. What's that mean? Like, so you're going to put negative 7.55.
It's 10 to the negative 7.55.
It's 10, on your calculator it probably looks like this. That's what you want. Is that what you're saying?
Wait, so it would be like, it's spitting out like 0.0000028, like it's like the same thing,
okay.
But it won't spit it out the scientific notation. Like, is that?
Yeah, perfect. All right, this one is the one you handed.
Hey, Alex. Alex, do you have my agenda?
How'd you do it?
No?
Magic. All right, everybody good?
Wait, I got a question.
Okay.
2.812.
Where is L anti-log on this?
She has your calculator. Ask Kelsey.
What? Craig, did you find an agenda?
What do you need to find?
Second. Well.
And the last one. Now. Here is the question that you've been longing for. Here it's asking you to calculate the hydrogen concentration, but you're given a POH. So, what's a strategy that we can use to answer this? And I know you guys like the shortest route possible, so. Okay, you know the POH. It's right here.
No, find the like analog and everything for the POH.
Okay.
And then subtract from 14.
Find the pH.
Find the pH. Let's do that.
Okay.
Because we know that pH plus POH equals 14, right? So you know this, and you know this. So to find the pH, actually, let's.
It's 11.55.
So to find the pH, it'll be equal to 14 minus 2.45, which was what again?
11.55.
Okay, 11.55. Does everybody see what I'm doing there? Okay. There's three possible ways to work this out. As long as you're using your processes, I don't care. Some of you may even want to find the hydroxide concentration and do what you did for the homework last night. By using the 1.0 times 10 to the negative 14. That's an option. It's up to you. Okay. This is probably the easier and quicker way. So once you have this, then to get your hydrogen concentration.
So do we not take
it? I'm sorry?
Do we not find the OH first?
No, it was given. Do you?
Or like the, we don't take that, the negative that to hold it.
That's an option, and I can show that here in a minute, but that's the longer way. That's the more adventurous route, which is fine. So once we have this, then we can take the anti-log.
Wait,
2 point. Okay. So that's one way you could work it out, and that's fine, that's legal. What Alex was trying to get across was...
Hey, Craig.
Uh-huh.
Switch the 8 and the 1.
So it's 8-1?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
So, Mr. Craig, I got 3.5.
Nope. All right. Now, what Alex was talking about... Okay. What Alex was suggesting, okay, we have a POH of 2.45, and again, this is an option, it's not a requirement. That's the nice thing about this, is that you could find your hydroxide concentration by going right for the jugular right off the bat, 2.45, which will give you something. -10^-3. Okay. And then to find the hydrogen concentration, you use what we did yesterday over the hydroxide. Okay. And then so we just did the 3.55, we found it. And it'll equal the same thing. Okay. So your options are open. Okay. And that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. And then there's even a third way.
Mr. Craig, I didn't even want to know the first.
We'll just leave it at that. I don't want to show the third way. I don't want to freak you guys out.
I thought acid's going to be easy. It's going to be
oh, they are. They're very easy. I agree.
Are we done?
Then I got to Y, and now I don't know.
All right, so the homework is the fives and sixes.